Well, here's a video of my daily drive from my home address to the city Vordingborg, approximately 10 kilometers from home. I have set up my iPhone in the front desk of my old Peugeot 405, and I'm going now. Enjoy the tour and the nice country. I'm just correcting here a bit. So I hope you can see the road now. Just had to correct a bit more. So it is the 7th of March 2016. And spring has come to Denmark, even to Denmark. It has been rather cold here until for a couple of days ago. Now we have about 8 degrees or 9 degrees of Celsius, and that's kind of nice compared to 2 or 3 degrees of Celsius, which is rather freezing even here in Denmark. This is a nice road to drive on because there's not that much traffic and there are a lot of turns, so I like a road which has a lot of turns and it is not just going straight out after a line, because that could be a kind of boring to drive on. Here in the countryside for over 20 years, and this makes us as one of the few housekeepers or house owners who have lived here for the longest period of time. Almost all the other residents here on this road are newcomers, or they have moved to here after that we moved to here in 95. So we are going to make a right turn here on the community road, which is a larger road in this countryside. There was no traffic. The time is 12 minutes past 11, so there's almost no traffic even here on the community road because of the rush hours. This first beginning again about 2:30 very nice to ride now. Now coming to the little city, which is a urban city to Vordingborg, and it is a city called Ørslev. We have a bus traffic company here, Ørslev tourist traffic, and we have a malt brewery from Carlsberg in this little town, so that's a world-known company, a beer brewing company from Denmark. So it is laying here in this little town. So that's kind of nice to us because it creates some work places for the local community. But aside from that, in Ørslev there are only living about a couple of thousand people, so it's not a very large city. Going uphill here from Ørslev to Vordingborg. I'm driving at the old national road here in Denmark, which was the main road from the ferry from Rødby, that means from German to Denmark, and that was before the motorway was coming. Then this road was the only road to Copenhagen. So for 30 years ago or 31 years ago, before Farøborn, the Farø Bridge came, this was heavily loaded with lots of cars and trucks from 24 hours 365 days a year. But that was that time, and traffic has of course increased, so we are happy that we have the motorway which carries the huge traffic. Going here to the last piece of Copenhagen road, Københavnsvej in Danish. Actually, I'm going to wash my car here, but because of the nice weather, I would like to take a little turn. To the castle, Vordingborg Castle. So Vordingborg is an old castle town. It is a fortified town here in Denmark, and it was built by Valdemar Victory, an old king here in Denmark. Old king. he lived in about the 1300th century, so it's around 700-800 years ago. Here you can see a tower which is called the Goose Tower, and that's the that's the only remaining medieval tower in Denmark, which is completely not restored, because it has always been there since it was built, and it was not teared down as the rest of the castle was during the 16th and 17th century, where the bricks was used to build common houses here in Vordingborg. So we are driving at a Copenhagen Road, Københavnsvej. And if I'm driving straight out, we are coming to the Vordingborg Castle. It's a huge tourist attraction here in this area, and it has also a driving direction at the motorway, so, or highway if you want to. See the goose tower there, and we can see the waterfront around this former castle. So it is also kept, or they have constructed it again here. It's just for a couple of years ago that they have to build some new basins for the water, because else it would just go down to the harbor. I think I will just park here a short moment of time. Well, I can't park here.
No.
Let's just park here anyway. I'm now taking my phone out of the... this castle. Oh, sorry. So as you can see, Vordingborg Castle. It's a rather large castle, or was. Let's just go around this castle. Can try. You just in a moment, we're going now. But here in Vordingborg, we are used to this castle, so it is nothing new to us, but I guess to other people it could be interesting, and to you here on YouTube, it could be a target for this year's tourist season. Maybe on your vacation to Denmark, come here to Vordingborg and take a look at our nice castle. There are several excavations which is ongoing through the last 20 years, and there's also a castle center which is very well visited. I'm just going past here in a moment so you can see. I'm just waiting here for the lights to come green. See, there are some nice remains of the castle. entrance to the castle center. Hvor kører 15? There was an unhappy driver because of the was holding a truck there and was stopping the oncoming traffic. Well, this was a view of the Vordingborg Castle. I hope you liked it. And now I will place my phone into the holder again so I can concentrate on my driving. Just a moment. I don't know what you call it in English. Some gate town or gate street. It is a very old street here in Vordingborg. We are driving here at Valdemarsgade or Valdemar Street. It is also a medieval name, named from the king Valdemar of Denmark, Valdemar Victory or Valdemar Sire, who created the Vordingborg Castle. Going left here on I just forgot what the street was called. Just a moment, I will tell you. Oh well, there was no street name here. That's a kind of embarrassing when you cannot remember the street name of your hometown. Well, I drive here every day and I don't notice the street names. I think a lot of people has it this way also. Oh, there we have it. The Boulevard. So we are driving off the Algade now, all streets, and we are driving to the western part of the city, because that's where I'm going to to the service station and wash my car here. And we are crossing Kuskevej and Elme Alley. And we have just crossed De Gyldne Hjørne, the Golden Corner, which is announced the best pizza bakery in Denmark. So this we also have here in Vordingborg. So please remember that when you are going to visit Vordingborg as a tourist this season. So I am about here at the service station, and there are only one car in front of me in the queue. So I will say thank you for now, and I will hope that you will enjoy watching my video. Bye bye.